Did you know that you can actually go live with pre-recorded videos? It's pretty amazing. Hey guys, this is Faye from Feisworld Media, and in this video, I want to show you step by step how you can use the schedule feature within Restream, yes, a multi-streaming software, to go live with pre-recorded videos. You can actually have a video editor, a producer, to create this video ahead of time. So whatever type of events you're running, you can then go live with pre-recorded videos. Now let's take a look at how the scheduler actually works for Restream. Once you log into Restream, what you want to do is click on this little calendar button right here. This will take you to the scheduler and takes just a couple of seconds to load. Once you're here, you are welcomed by two tabs. One is called Events and the other is called Videos. You'll notice that under Videos, I already have some videos scheduled and already released previously. And here under Events is something that you can schedule an upcoming event. So let me go ahead and demonstrate from there. To schedule your first event, either click on Schedule Event, this icon over here, or the big bright one over here, will take you to the same things. And you'll notice that also in this video dropdown, again, there is a demo video from Restream, but there's also a video I uploaded earlier. First, I want to demonstrate what a free account looks like. So I just signed up for a free account so that you can see the limitations on what you can and cannot do with a free account within Restream. Yes, you can still access Scheduler. You still have the Events and Videos tab, as you can see here. And so the limitation here is free for videos up to 1 gigabyte and 30 minutes long. Now, if you are a content creator doing this on a regular basis, you can imagine that you can go a long way with even the restrictions here. And now you can add channels on Restream that includes YouTube, Facebook, Periscope, and you can see a long list of all the channels here that you can access as well. So the real restriction, in my opinion, based on what I can see right here, is really just the video file size and how long the broadcast is. Now, you may be wondering, I am good with free account right now. What if I want to upgrade? So here's the good news that if you really like Scheduler, which I do, and creates a lot of convenience and freedom from the type of work I do, then you can consider upgrading to a plan. So the small plan right here is that you can have up to 60 minutes of duration and 2 gigabyte per file and also 2Q stream. Now, there are two other options as well. As you can see, medium and large, quickly go over here. You can have up to 5 gigabyte limit per file, 5Q streams for medium, no stream branding, and also the duration is longer too. Lastly, large, 240 minute of duration limit, 10 gigabyte of a limit per file, 10Q streams. So you get the idea. And one more thing I would say it's really interesting is event looping, which means that you can loop the event. You can have these events scheduled in the loop, which means it can just automatically broadcast for more than once. Now let's take a look at how you go about scheduling an event. By the way, this part of the tutorial I feel really confident about because Restream's scheduler is actually really intuitive to use. So step one, you want to upload a video. So it can be multiple videos. These are pre-produced videos. Again, I mentioned my clients who are in the music, orchestra, and educational industry really enjoy this feature. So all you have to do is click on the blue button and just upload your video. Another feature is that within this drop-down icon, when you click on it, now you can upload files also from Dropbox and Google Drive. As you can see, I uploaded my documentary, Feisworld, on Amazon. And what I'm trying to do, again, this doesn't have to be your strategy, is for my 13-minute episode of documentary, I want to broadcast this on Saturday at noon without me even being there. So it's really quite cool. So once you uploaded the video, you immediately have two options. You can get rid of it or you can schedule this to go live. So you can click on schedule. This will take you to this screen. Now, another way to do that is go back to the event button and you can click on either of the schedule event button to also populate that window. Now, as you can see, you can give it a title, and this title doesn't have to be what comes with the video file. You can give it a title that's way more compelling. Another message I would like to call out is
keep in mind that actually takes some setup time on the back end for a Restream to stream and schedule these videos. So if you have an event that's going to go live at 1 p.m., then I highly recommend, you know, in general, that you want to make sure that you have that planned at least an hour or two ahead of time. So this warning message here is to say that, you know, all files over the 2 gigabyte limit are scheduled at least 2 hours in advance. So the bigger the file, the longer it takes for Restream to pick it up, to stream and prepare the file. But in general, definitely try to do this, I would say, the day before at least, or a couple of hours beforehand. You can change the title here, but you can also select the video. You see, I can change between different videos selected, and right here you can select the time. Now, the timestamp here is clearly indicated where you are. My time right here is New York, so it's Eastern Standard Time, and you can schedule the date as soon as the same day, right, as we talked about, and it's going to give you a time here. Now, this time is the soonest it can go live for your video. As I'm recording this, it is 8:50 p.m., so as you can see, based on this 13-minute video, which is nowhere near a 2 gigabyte file size, is telling me that the earliest they can go live with this video is 15 minutes from where I am. Just as FYI. Now you can click on the advanced button here. As you can see, you now have the option to toggle on and off individual channels that you want to go live with these videos. You have the options to also toggle all of them on or off. Here you can select whether you want to repeat this scheduler as well. Usually I select don't repeat, but you are certainly welcome to say 3 times and there's an interval. So which means think of at the old days on CBS or, you know, Lifetime, these channels will loop such as Seinfeld or whatever TV show that was popular in the old days and just keep looping them. So you are able to do that, but you can only repeat this on an interval. Now, event looping itself is a paid feature, which we just talked about. So if that's something you need, then consider upgrading. Now, you can actually select right here the streaming ingest is set automatically to the nearest server according to your location. Again, I'm definitely closest to New York. If you live elsewhere, for example, like in Europe somewhere, then you can select that. And keep in mind that by changing this parameter, which means you're doing it manually, as opposed to letting Restream select that for you, you may affect the quality of your stream. So once everything looks good and you have selected the time, all you have to do is then schedule the live event. Now, I want to do something just a couple of hours out, so I have the option to also show you how I can cancel the event. So I'm going to give it a title, Feisworld Documentary Series, Crossing Borders with Basila Bukoko and Sarah Cooper. Well, as you can see here, the length of the title must be between 4 to 70 characters, so you do want to keep it brief and make sure that it's, you know, immediately identifiable and compelling to your audience wherever you're streaming this content. Now, if everything looks good, just click on Schedule Live Event. Now, I actually really like this update within Restream. This came about recently, and as you can see, now under Events, you can schedule multiple events. It's like having that events page on your website. And right here, you can see it's Saturday and at what time, which time, and you can see all the channels. And you can click on this +4, the plus sign here, to see all the channels that I will be going live with this content. And it says the duration of this series, etc. So to edit this, what you want to do is click on this 3 dots and simply edit the events. So that will take you back to what we were just looking at, obviously, and you can also just delete this event using this delete button right here. Again, the scheduler feature is actually super helpful and very intuitive for the most part. So I hope you enjoy this and let me know how it goes. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, and there will be many more videos related to Restream and all of these features that you're seeing within the Restream studio, how you can go about using it, whether you're an individual or you're a business. I can't wait to see you in a future video. Give us a thumbs up or down. Let us know how we're doing and what else you would like to learn from Restream, from multi-streaming, simulcasting. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Now, if you're a musician, or you run an orchestra, or you're an entertainment company, whatever it may be, you understand that Zoom has made it pretty impossible. And the reason for that is
Zoom was originally designed for regular conferences, and it just does not have the ability to handle multiple audio channels, at least not right now in the middle of the pandemic in 2020. So what I would recommend that you do is to pre-produce videos that you wouldn't otherwise be able to do live. So for example, if you're an orchestra, you may have, you know, multiple team members, instruments, conductors. So let me give you another example. If you are a filmmaker, a very serious content creator who spend, you know, weeks and months working on a piece of video, then there's more reason for you to do that as well. I love using Restream Scheduler because it allows me to tease out a single episode from my documentary and launch it to whatever platform I want. Because Restream is a multi-streaming platform, that means there's so many output channels I can choose from, including some of the Chinese ones as well, which I'll be talking about in a future video.